quarter of adults in Britain are so obsessed with cleaning and tidying that they spend 2.5 hours or more every weekday on household chores, with many feeling compelled to abide by strict regimes and rituals.
The thought of the dust in my house drives me crackers, so I've got a hoover within an inch of my life.
I take 2 sandwich bags, I put 1 on each hand, and then I'll clean.
9, 10, 9, 10, 9, 10. Then I can move on.
But for most of us, keeping our homes clean and tidy is not a priority. With the average family carpet being 4,000 times dirtier than a loo seat, and only a third of us washing our hands after we use the toilet.
Oh!
Literally, a part of me has just died inside.
It's just horrendous.
Can a group of obsessive cleaners transform the habits of a nation?
Can't even get the door open, can you?
You've got dog feces. This is the stuff I'm having to deal with.
I think I'll knock with me feet.
Or will changing the lives of those with a very different attitude to cleanliness prove too much for our compulsive cleaners?
Where do you start? Where do you bloody start, Sonia?
That's a 4-bedroom dog kennel.
Whose need for perfection has become an obsession.
They're all over the work surface and it's just something that I couldn't deal with.
You're just walking off like some sort of...
Clive needs to put his hand down his pants, find his balls and make a decision.
Mother and daughter, Leslie and Tuesday Turner from Bridgend, live a clutter and germ-free existence, cleaning for up to 16 hours a day.
I will hoover 2-3 hours a day. The thought of the dust, the particles in my house drives me crackers. So I've got to hoover within an inch of my life.
I bleach my bathroom for 2 hours a day. I've got to do it, else I can't settle. Isn't that a lovely sight? It's better than any naked man. Any naked man at all, that does more for me than that.
Recently diagnosed with OCD, Leslie dedicates 90% of her waking hours solely scrubbing, bleaching and dusting her immaculate home.
When you talk about OCD, people go, oh, I've got that. I like to turn my tins or I like my pens a certain way or I like... That is not OCD, babe. Come and have a day in my head. Then you'd know what OCD really means.
When it's there on your mind, it's with you. All the time.
Part-time student Tuesday, also diagnosed with OCD, ensures she cleans for at least 6 hours a day, meaning there is little time for friends, and no guests have been allowed in the Turner household for 5 years.
I don't want anyone in because they're going to sit on my furniture or touch my walls or touch the doors.
Yeah.
Our OCD's quite different. She's a germ phobe.
I'm looking for germs. Yours is, like, the minimalistic thing.
I hate all this. This does my head in. If she wasn't here, the room would be empty.
And if she's been in here, I know straight away. And then I know if she's touched something on here, she's touched everything else in my room as well. Everything needs to be decontaminated.
Anti-backed.
Yeah.
With Leslie's commitment to cleaning, controlling every aspect of her life, she's worried that Student Tuesday will follow suit.
I want her to get some help now because I don't want to reach 60 and be like me.
No life, no friends.
I mean, I don't want friends because he might want to come to my house.
Leslie and daughter Tuesday are taking 4 days away from home and their 16-hour-a-day cleaning routine to help someone they have never met.
We're not taking a lot of clothes because we don't want our things to get infected.
Dirty and contaminated.
Even though we're taking overalls and gloves.
We've got wet wipes and everything, so we're gonna be fine.
Yeah.
I think we are doing this because we would like to make people more aware of OCD and understand it a little bit better. I think like doing something like this might begin to maybe sort of help our OCD.
Tuesday and Leslie will be helping 47-year-old single mother Sonia from Farnham in Hampshire, who has filled her home with 20 years' worth of clutter.
I'm quite creative, so where
someone else might see this and they'll think, like, that needs to go there, that needs to go there. My brain's not thinking that. I'm thinking, oh, I could make those flowers that are now dying off into potpourri. Or I'll think about rearranging the furniture rather than cleaning the furniture out. You know, unfortunately, I've now got to the point where I've had so much clutter, I can't even rearrange my furniture.
Sonia hasn't cleared a single item out of her house for 2 years.
Things that were easily attainable, I just can't reach anymore because the clutter has just eclipsed it all. There's no privacy in the house. You can't shut the bathroom door, so that means no private showers or baths anymore. My home's suffocating. It was a functional home a few years ago, but now it's become just too chaotic. You wouldn't know it from looking at here, but I am actually house proud.
OCD diagnosed Tuesday and Leslie, who spend 16 hours a day cleaning, have just 4 days to try to turn Sonia's neglected house back into a home.
How are we going to do this?
You'll have to knock. I'm not touching the door.
Okay. I think I'll knock with my feet rather than touching the door, just in case.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. I'm Sonia.
Hi. I'm sorry, I can't shake your hand. I have OCD with June.
Okay, no problem. That's okay.
Nice to meet you.
Would you like to come
in? Okay, I'm Leslie and this is my daughter Tuesday.
Hi.
Where do you eat? How do you live? How do you sit at the table? Bikes? Why are your bikes in your kitchen, babe?
Because I've had one stolen in the past.
You don't cook?
I do cook.
Do you? Oh my God, God. Oh, Jesus. You do not cook in there.
I do cook in there.
You're going to die.
I haven't died yet.
This is threadbare, Sonia, this is. When did this last get hoovered? Look at this. It's threadbare, babes.
Yeah.
Rip it up just to have bare stuff.
This is a spare room. This was Connor's room when he lived
here. This is a room.
And he moved out 2 years ago, and it's now become a storage room.
The stuff's to the ceiling, Sonia.
I know.
You know, all the things in here, there's like some of it stuff that you could just bin and get rid of.
Yeah, I'd say there probably is. Friends give me things as well, and I find it hard to say no.
Well, just say thank you very much and put it in the skip. If she buys me something, a Christmas present, if I don't want it, it goes in the bin.
Yeah.
And that's my own daughter.
Yeah. I find that quite harsh.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, and this is my bedroom.
Where's your wardrobe?
That's my wardrobe.
How'd you get in it?
I don't.
How do you change the bed?
At the moment, I'm just sleeping on my sleeping bag.
Oh, it's not a nice lady's room, is it, babe? It's not a nice
It was once, but it isn't anymore, no.
My mind is going crazy now. Where do you start? Where do you bloody start, Sonia? I can't really say much more about this room. I really need to get out of here because it's doing me head in.
Okay.
I feel dirty from head to toe. I feel disgusting.
I feel a bit sorry for her, but a little bit annoyed as well. I won't give her a kick up the backside and say, you know, pull your finger out, girl, throw it out, it's rubbish. It's just messing with your mind. You'll feel a lot cleaner when it's out of your way.
With a huge amount of work to be done in just 4 days, Tuesday and Leslie prepare Sonia for what they have in store.
I don't know if you've got it by now, but I'm a minimalist and she's a germaphobe.
Right.
On average, I wash my hands about 40 to 50 times a day. But in between that, I'm forever antibacterial in and wet wiping my hands. And if ever I'm out and I touch something and I can't get to a sink and some soap, then I'll antibac and that'll make me okay then.
Every day I can spend between 8 and 16 hours cleaning. I spend a good hour in the bathroom first, but that's on my face and my appearance, even though I'm not going out. And then I have to start dusting then. And the dusting starts maybe between 2 and 3 hours. Then bleaching, bleaching all the time. After it's bleached, it's polished, it's anti-bact. And that's every day.
They don't seem to have any life but cleaning. It seems to have taken over everything.
We don't cuddle or kiss.
Oh, that's sad.
Yeah. Butterfly kisses or a...
From an air kiss, room, air yeah. Kiss. Air kisses,
from across the room. Wow.
Yeah.
No hugs?
No.
Oh,
no. Not even each other, no, I know.
That's sad.
In Britain, the average adult spends less than half the time cleaning than we did 50 years ago. But there is a unique group of obsessively clean individuals who are bucking the trend.
The reason why I use a toothbrush is it gets into all those little corners that a cloth cannot get into.
Vinnie G is a gym owner and fitness instructor from Sheffield who lives his life in complete order.
If it's not in line, then something's wrong, and that makes me feel uncomfortable, and I don't like to feel uncomfortable.
On top of running his own business, Vinnie spends up to 3 entire months of every year just cleaning, tidying and grooming.
I hate any form of hair. I shave my armpits, I do my man bits.
Not hygienic as far as I'm concerned.
In his gym, every barbell, machine and bench has its place, and Vinnie ensures his equipment is kept in the best working order.
Yeah. Just get it wiped down, please.
Come on, you're having a laugh. What about this? Thank you.
Don't like sweat drying on the machine, so I always put the Dettol on top of it to make sure it doesn't dry.
And it's not only his gym equipment that Vinnie likes to keep germ-free.
I anti-back about 100 times a day. It's usually when I touch a client or touch the bench or the weights.
Vinnie believes that his compulsion to clean could be beneficial to others. He's taking 4 days out of his own obsessive cleaning routine to come to Margate on the Kent coast to help a complete stranger.
I'm going to tackle it the same way I deal with my clients, really. I'm always being to the point, and I'll say it as it is. Hopefully, I won't offend him too much, but I'm sure he'll understand, or I'll make him understand to a certain degree. What have I got myself into?
Five years ago, Robin Vaughan Lyons and his partner Kevin bought this rundown Victorian property.
People don't come to visit the house. It's too embarrassing. It really is a disaster house. The more I've dug into it, the more problems I've found.
The state of the house is not held by Robin's 6 dogs.
My bedroom has completely been taken over by the dogs. The floor drobe just extends everywhere, and the dogs use it as their dog bed. And the main bed as well, of course.
With the dogs being top priority, the house hasn't had a deep clean since they moved in.
I don't have a problem with cleaning and tidying. I don't do it.
Partner and co-owner Kevin only stays one night every 2 weeks in the house and spends the rest of the time with his mum.
It's very stressful. It's, I think it does affect our relationship a lot. It's got to the point where I spend more time here at the allotment than I do at home.
I think I need a lot of help. Obviously, things have got completely out of hand now. I don't want to carry on living like this. I'd love this house to be tidy before I'm 50 at the end of the month.
Hello, hello, hello. Wow.
Home, crap, home.
How are you doing?
Fine.
Would you mind if I ask you to?
Yeah.
I'm not being offensive, but yeah, you've got an animal in your hand. My name's Vinnie.
Nice, Vinnie. Robin.
Robin. Oh. That smell is quite strong. And, do you mind if I just step out?
No, I don't mind.
All right, thank you. Dear, oh dear. Ooh. Just the sheer smell of the dog's urine all over that place is absolutely lethal.
Another drama queen in my house. It should be good fun. If he thinks the hall's bad, wait till he sees the rest of the house.
In. Be good, be good, be good, be good. Come on, in.
Oh, my God. Oh, God. That is the strongest smell ever. Oh, God. Do you actually cook in here and eat in here?
Yeah, of course I do.
Really?
Yeah, of course.
You're single?
No.
You're not? No. And your partner lives here with you?
Occasionally.
Wow, and she doesn't mind?
He does mind.
He does mind?
He does mind.
Hence the reason why he's not here very often. Mm. Wow. Do you not want to change it for that purpose only?
Of course I do.
Right. Okay.
This is welcome to my living room.
Wow. God. You can't get to anything. How are you going to clean? Wait a minute. That's a dog on top of your clothes.
Mm-hmm.
I'm flabbergasted.
Okay, let me show you upstairs. Save the best to last.
Oh!
This is the bathroom.
Oh, my God. I just dread to think what your bedroom's like. Why haven't you cleaned this stuff out, Robin? I mean, come on, man.
I just got out of hand.
Because I'm sure the dogs, if they stay in here from time to time, do they sleep on this floor as well?
Yeah.
Please don't tell me they get under the sheets with you.
Yeah, of course. Some of them were bored in the bed.
Right, OK. Is this house feeling more like a kennel or an house at the moment to you?
No, it's a four-bedroom dog kennel.
It's a four-bedroom dog kennel. Yeah. Robin, we've got some work to do, mate.
Oh, certainly have. Vinny's crazy. He's totally over the top. I have never, ever come across anybody like him before. I'm sure he's a very nice man, but thank God I don't live with him. We'd kill each other, I think, within minutes.
Full-time personal trainer Vinny wants to make it clear to Robin just how strict a cleaning regime he finds acceptable.
I clean 5-6 hours a day, every day. From my bedroom to my bathroom to my kitchen to my living room.
It's not an operating theatre, it's my home.
But Vinny's uncompromising attitude to cleanliness is very deep-rooted.
As a child, lived on the streets for a couple of years, and because of the way I lived on the streets, which wasn't very nice, I didn't want to replicate that in my own home. Hence the reason where my cleansiness started to come from. I just like perfection. That's who I am.
Do you want to start taking this down?
Yeah.
And I'll start passing stuff to the door.
In Farnham, Leslie and Tuesday are taking on three of the rooms in single mother Sonia's home, which haven't had a full clean in 2 years, starting with the floor-to-ceiling clutter that has taken over the back room.
And this is for...
I had water in it.
OK.
Leslie's strategy is to get everything out of the house to decide what comes back in and what goes.
I need a space to put things. So before we can bring the stuff out, I'm going to have to deal with this. My garden is nothing like this. I cut the grass with scissors. So I've got to really get stuck into this and try and make a little bit of sense of it.
With Leslie tackling the lawn, germaphobe Tuesday, who spends 2 hours a day cleaning her bedroom, is working on the back room with Sonia. 1 hour in, Tuesday is struggling and has to confront a major fear.
I need a drink.
Right.
I really need a drink so bad. But before I do, please could I, because I got to have a drink out your tap, please would you mind if I just cleaned your tap first in the glass? Would you mind?
Yep.
Is that right?
No, that's okay.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. But I can't drink out of this tap. There's so much grime around the edge of it, so I don't know what's coming out of it. So I don't want to be drinking bacteria. So I need to bleach it before I can have anything, and the glass as well, because it's filthy.
Tuesday is so terrified of germs, she washes her hands 50 times a day and finds touching anything, even in her own home, a daily challenge.
Ew, oh, that's not the sponge. I was using the wrong sponge. I was using this sponge originally because it's new, it hasn't been touched, and then I bloody just used that one. Oh, Jesus Christ. I didn't realise it was that bloody sponge I was using. So I just put bleach in the glass to just kill the germs that are on that sponge. I just put in the glass. still don't like drinking out. I still don't know what bacteria is like coming out of the. Okay.
Leslie's still persevering, trying to make a space to start moving Sonia's 20 years worth of clutter into, and it's become clear she has a mammoth task ahead.
I really can't do anything. This needs a JCB and a team of 25 men. I feel angry and defeated, and I'm so messed up in my mind at this minute because this is out of my control.
One in 50 people in Britain are diagnosed with obsessive compulsive disorder. For some of these, this can manifest itself in an obsessive fear of germs and a compulsion to clean.
If it's not right, I've got to keep on straightening it and keep on doing it until it's perfect.
And when it comes to the world outside, it can be a terrifying place.
Oh my God, oh my God. So dirty.
In Sussex, mum of three, Hayley, was diagnosed with OCD in 2007. She spends £800 a year on bleach, trying to keep her home sterile.
OCD, it's like a doubting illness. You doubt what germs are there, you're constantly thinking about the cleanliness of things.
To test if the world outside her home is as dirty as she fears, Hayley is joining forces with fellow obsessive compulsive cleaners to take themselves out of their comfort zone.
I've always been told to push my boundaries. Then it'd be nice as well for me to help other people suffering with it.
No. Terrible! You should be ashamed.
Your bum is cleaner than your hands.
This week, joining Hayley is 46-year-old gym owner and perfectionist Mark from Surrey.
Who pulled these this morning? Is this you?
Yeah. What's wrong with them?
Along with 37-year-old order-obsessed Richard from Northamptonshire, whose compulsions are not just limited to his home.
If I see a can that's there, I suppose, yeah, bring it to the front.
Together, they're going to be testing one of the biggest sources of anxiety for obsessive cleaners. Toilets. With the average person passing over 25 stone of excrement a year, unsurprisingly, over 4 million Brits are frightened of pooing away from home.
I think public toilets, they are full of germs. I think as well they smell.
But before they face the public loos...
Hello!
Hi!
Mark and Richard have come to see how a germaphobe keeps her own toilet pristine.
This is my bathroom.
Wow! Sparkly. I can smell bleach, Hayley.
I started cleaning yesterday. At 1 o'clock, and I wasn't finished until 8. And I'm going to give it another quick burst.
Although she bleaches the toilet at least 5 times a day...
Now, I'm going to get the big guns out.
She only steam cleans it once.
Look, it's like a magical smoking toilet. Amazing.
I'd be surprised if there's any germs at all after that onslaught.
I don't think they could have withstood that.
To see if it's as clean as it looks, they use a machine that checks hospital sanitation levels. A reading of 500 or under is considered clean enough for food preparation.
How are you feeling?
Terrified.
Wow.
What?
What is it?
Yeah. Free!
Oh my God!
Shut your mouth!
Hayley's toilet is almost as clean as a surgeon's scalpel. Now they're ready to face their biggest fears.
Literally, a part of me has just died inside. I feel like I want to get out this toilet.
In Margate, Vinny's tackling 3 rooms in dog lover Robin's house. With the dogs at his dad's, the boys are starting with the living room, which hasn't been touched since Robin moved in 5 years ago.
You need to decide pretty much what you're going to get rid of and what's staying. The skip's come now, and now we can really step into this.
This mess has created a massive wedge in Robin's relationship with partner Kevin, who stays over just one day a fortnight.
Yeah, that is a very special picture, mate. And you look both very, very happy there indeed.
My hope for the end of the week is that when the house is in a presentable condition, that he'll
he'll come round and spend more time here with me.
With Vinnie determined to sort the room and Robin anxious to get partner Kevin to spend more time there, clearing gets off to a good start.
I think we're going to get somewhere today. Definitely. Brilliant. Happy days. This carpet has got to be really looked at going in the skip, because look at the state of it.
Grab the other end. Let's just squeeze it together first.
Yeah.
Vinny, who hates hair so much he shaves his entire body daily, is struggling with the hair left behind from Robin's six animals.
Yeah, I'm itching a little bit now. And that's just because, yeah. We need to carry on with the stuff, but first of all, I need to go to the pub or the shop nearby to go to the toilet.
Why can't you use mine?
I would prefer not to use the bathroom.
Seriously?
Yeah, I clean my toilet every single day.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe two or three or four times a day.
I don't even vaguely understand where you're coming from. I appreciate that's your thing and that's what you need to do, so that's fine, but I don't understand it. I don't know why he's making such a big deal of everything. I guess that's just the way he is, that's how dreadfully obsessive he is.
In Farnham, Obsessive Compulsive's Tuesday and Leslie are at their hotel, bracing themselves for another day at Sonia's. Leslie shaves her face daily to make sure it's totally bacteria-free.
I can't do any rituals, but at least I can keep everything clean. I've got everything on tissues in there. I've got it as ordered and as tidy as I possibly can here.
Their morning routine complete, the ladies make their way to Sonia's to tackle her bedroom.
Hello.
Morning.
Morning, babes.
Right, we really need to sort this bedroom. So you can have a little bit of lady space, a little bit of time on your own.
Sonia's bedroom hasn't had a proper clear out since the breakdown of her relationship 2 years ago.
This is only about 2 weeks old.
I don't want a description, just give it me.
Yeah,
but fold it.
You asked, you made a comment.
Okay, get it, come on.
Leslie's keen for Sonia to get rid of as much as possible by the end of the day. In her own home, Leslie can't bear any clutter and won't even have a picture frame on display in her bedroom.
Keeping.
Dressing gown. Keeping going. Keeping.
The keeping pile is a lot bigger than the getting rid of pile.
I know I've held on to everything now, and
everything.
I know it's too much.
Yeah.
I know it's too much, and I know it has to go, but it's just really hard actually letting go.
You're getting on my nerves now because we're not moving fast enough, and I can't see anything leaving the room.
The dust in the air just is not. It just makes me feel uncomfortable. It just makes me feel dirty.
Okay. But that can go now. You've instructed that one. So can't you just, because it's too heavy for me. Thank you.
Okay, I need to leave because I'm really, really, really hot.
I think it's a bit overwhelming for her.
Yeah.
I just feel so dirty. The dust from that, from her dirty room and her dirty clothes have been stored there for years is on me and I feel vile.
Okay.
Right. Oh, we've nearly finished. Sorry. Is that over the line? Sorry.
A little bit. It's just so stuffy in here, and then the smells in the air, it's like, it's really affecting my OCD so bad. I just want to just get it out. We just need to get the stuff that we're...
This isn't stuff to me. This is my stuff.
Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Please remember, this is my home. And continually, you two are slagging me down and putting me down. We all have our own little issues, yeah? Can we just start respecting each other a bit now,
okay,
please?
Okay, we totally respect your home, but do you understand? We haven't come here to be horrible to you.
Yeah, but
we want to help you. We want to get you. We want to sort your house out and make it organised and neat and tidy and more comfortable
but
for you.
You're expecting me, not asking me, you're expecting me to put your condition first. And all I'm getting from you is judgment and looking down. Stern faces looking down on me and probably slagging me off behind my back. This is about working as a team to get this done.
Okay.
We've really started to test our OCD. We've pushed ourselves. And she's not pushing herself.
No.
She is to an extent, but not half as much as we are with our kind of problems.
We're sniffing dirt. all the time.
It's just frustrating because I know I've got to have stuff done, but when someone's saying, oh, this bit of tack, you know, it's mine. It's my bit of tack.
Hello, Arnie's. Any progress?
Getting there.
Good. Okay, Sonny, can we just resolve this, like? I know we're both far apart, but we'll have to, disagree on a lot of things, but,
I accept that, but it's the way you speak to me. You speak to me like a bit of dirt on the
I don't mean anything personal. Okay. I promise you.
Yeah. That's not how it's come across, but I accept that. Okay, thank you. Yeah. Let's get on with this.
I think there's a lot of similarities between us, though, Sonia. I mean, we're both lonely.
No, that's true. I've been let down. I've had two failed relationships with the father of my children.
I've never been in a loving relationship. Never. I've never been married. I've never had a man who's loved me. Tuesday loves me, but it's a different sort of love. Yeah. I want that love half a man.
Yeah.
But they don't love me. They see the OCD and they're off.
Yeah, I guess we've both used our different ways of coping to push the outside or specific outside people away.
Away, yes. Yes, I agree with you, Sonia. I do totally agree, Shug.
Yeah.
Tuesday and Leslie have only a day left to clear Sonia's 20 years of clutter and are determined to clear the bedroom by the end of the day.
I can see where we're heading now.
Good.
And however painful the letting go, I'm glad I have.
I think we've just seen a light at the end of the tunnel. It's only a very small one, but at least we can see the light now. This morning we couldn't see one at all. But now we can see one, and this afternoon it's got that much bigger.
OCD diagnosed Hayley, accompanied by fellow obsessive cleaners Mark and Richard, are confronting their fears over using toilets in public places. So far, using a hospital germ counter, Hayley has discovered her own loo narrowly missed the operating theatre standard of zero.
Three!
Oh my God!
With 1.5 billion rail journeys made every year in the UK, train toilets are some of the most used in Britain. But not by Hayley.
Oh, Jesus.
This is the first time she's visited one in 20 years.
Just spraying it a little bit just to make me feel a bit more comfortable. Just to, like, not smell so toilety. It's really bothering me being in here. There's wee down the toilet.
Every year, a healthy adult passes over 900 pints of urine. That's 6.3 bathtubs worth.
I'm just going to do a fat wee down the toilet and then see how someone else can flush it. It's dirty.
A reading of 500 or under is considered clean enough for food preparation.
600.
This reading puts the train toilet at over 200 times dirtier than Hayley's loo.
Oh, no, I've touched that.
Knowing that only 50% of men wash their hands with soap, Hayley wants to examine the door handle.
Oh, my... Can you see that? Can you see that?
Literally, a part of me has just died inside. It's just gross.
A reading of 4,552 is considered a health hazard in the food industry.
It suggests that people aren't washing their hands when they come out of the toilets, and they're just, like, they've probably got poo on their hands, if I'm honest, and they're, like, smearing it all over the handle. It's everything I imagined it would be, and worse. I feel like I want to get out this toilet ASAP.
Next stop, a building site, where Mark will be confronting a particular childhood memory.
When I was a kid, I hid in a port-a-loo, leant back and actually put my hand down the toilet. So there's a particular hatred of port-a-loos for me. I'm going to do it.
Okay.
Go for it, Mark.
I don't think you particularly like the view here.
Is there feces?
There is. Hayley, can you do me a favour and hold the door open while I swab this? Push it with your box.
Well, I don't want my box touching it.
Over 100,000 portable toilets are in use at any one time in the UK.
It smells like fishy wee.
Each is designed to hold enough human waste for 10 people over a working week before reaching unsanitary conditions.
He's gonna gag. You're gonna go?
Oh.
Are you right, Mark? No.
Oh, God. That's a foul.
He's got to read it.
Shut up.
That's
1,844.
The portable toilet is 600 times dirtier than Haley's loo.
Mine was a free.
I felt really sorry for Mark.
Beautiful.
I think he was very brave.
Possibly my worst nightmare. Yeah. God.
It's an eye-opener, definitely.
In the end, neither the train nor the portable toilet produced an average reading that could be considered sanitary.
Generally, across the board, it was pretty minging.
That was horrendous, I felt.
But has the experience changed their habits?
Even though I felt quite triumphant in doing it, I don't think I'll be making that as a hobby. I don't think I'll be going into environmental health.
If I hadn't weed for a month, I still wouldn't use that toilet.
In Margate, Vinny's into day three of the four-day cleanup. With the living room sorted, Vinny's plan is to deep clean the bedroom.
At this rate, this is going to be a long job today, mate.
Robin's six dogs sleep with him every night. Without a proper clean for 5 years, they've certainly left their mark.
This is the stuff I'm having to deal with. Dog feces. Unfortunately, on my discovery, when you'd gone out of the room, you got dog feces down here, mate.
Lovely.
Yeah. This is an example of the dogs taking over, mate.
I'm no stranger to dog poo.
Mate, you've got to clean your hands, mate, yeah? Swap you. Fib, mate. Right, come on then, let's crack on. Robin, you've got dog poo there and dog poo there, and two places. What I'm going to do is just take 2 minutes while you just go outside and clear up if you don't mind.
OK.
Having gone through 10 bottles of antibac in the last 3 days, the discovery of dog feces has knocked Vinny.
Really struggling now. You shouldn't have to find that in someone's house, in the bedroom, underneath the clothes. I just don't know how anybody can even live like that.
Well, it's a house full of dogs, so I don't know what he's expecting. I think he's absolutely being a drama queen, as per usual, and just going over the top with the whole thing.
In Farnham, OCD diagnosed Leslie and Tuesday have just one day left to turn Sonia's neglected house back into a home.
We're both really going to push ourselves. My mum isn't going to wear her overalls, and I'm going to try my best not wear any gloves. But it's all part of, like, the experience, I think, to push the OCD as far as I can push it.
With the bedrooms clear, it's time for Tuesday and Leslie, who spend 3 hours a day cleaning their kitchen, to tackle Sonia's cupboards.
I did find a jar here it's 2008.
2008?
That can go.
Good girl. I did notice when you took the tins out. You did well, you took them out with no gloves.
It's an achievement. I'm very proud of you.
The cupboard's now organised. The ladies have just 2 hours to put the finishing touches to the house, ready to show Sonia's sister Sam the finished result.
I'd like to think that they've done it, but there was a lot to do, so I don't know 100%. If the house is clean, it gives Sonia a new lease on life, definitely.
Sonia's house was full of 20 years' worth of clutter and hadn't had a deep clean in 2 years. It's taken 90 man-hours of decluttering and cleaning. 15 bottles of bleach, 60 cloths to finally bring it up to par.
Oh, my God. It's beautiful. This is absolutely amazing. You and the boys are going to just be able to homework, dinners together.
clear house, clear mind.
Yeah. That's my motto. Yeah.
In the back room, a skip full of clutter has been removed, allowing it to become a habitable bedroom for Sonia's son.
Oh, God. You've done so much, haven't you?
It was up to the ceiling.
Yeah.
It was up to the ceiling.
I can't believe the transformation in how it was and what it's like now. It's actually quite a big box room, isn't it?
It is.
40 bags of Sonia's outfits have been removed, and finally she has her bedroom back.
That's beautiful. You can feel it and smell it.
No.
It sounds so lovely. Well done.
The reality is, if you girls had not come, I'd still be sitting in this.
And for Tuesday, who hasn't hugged someone for 3 years, there's been a surprising breakthrough.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lo.
Tuesday, you don't know how much that makes
me feel. Thank you so much. Oh, it's been lovely. It's been an experience. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you
very much.
Thank you.
Oh.
Hug you too.
Well done.
The achievement here, I personally didn't think in a million years we would have reached this level today. No way.
I've got my own space now. Somewhere I can relax and be me.
I'm amazed at my daughter. I'm really impressed. Hugging, drinking the water, taking the gloves off. And we're walking away like this. I'm amazed. I hope it's rubbed off a little bit. I hope some of it's rubbed off, yeah.
Yeah.
In Margate, it's the last day of the clean. Having filled the skip, Vinny is giving Robin a masterclass in oven cleaning.
Get a Brillo, and I want you to clean these, please. Yeah, Brillos are in the bags.
Why are you using a toothbrush on an oven, Vinny?
Because the friction from the toothbrush gets into the corners where you can't do with a cloth or a Brillo. Yeah? Trust me.
With the oven in Vinny's home taking a full 24 hours a week to clean, this is his final chance to impress on Robin. If a job's worth doing, it's worth doing properly.
Vinny, you're so obsessed you've scrubbed the damn numbers off my cooker.
What numbers?
Look!
There was no numbers there.
You've scrubbed them off. I don't know what's what now.
There was no numbers on there. Absolutely not. I can say that for a fact.
With Robin's partner Kevin, who sleeps over just one day a fortnight, expected in a matter of hours, the boys go into overdrive.
The house was in a pretty horrific state. I'm hoping when we get in, it's going to be wonderful. I'm really excited.
Four days ago, Robin's rooms were overwhelmed with 5 years' worth of dirt.
Ready for this?
Yeah.
What's that going to get you?
Oh, it's wonderful. There's just so much to take in. I can see work surfaces, real work surfaces. I can sit down and eat.
This is the man responsible. This is Vinny. Vinny, this is
Thank
Kevin.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. It's been hard work, but we've both worked at it, we've both been a team, and I know he wants to make a change and he wants to make a difference.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Well, I'm hoping now, we've got a nice clean kitchen, I'm hoping that you're going to spend some more time here.
I want to spend time here.
Good.
The living room used to be buried under a skip full of waste.
Open your eyes now.
Oh! Oh, that's lovely. That's speechless, actually. The room's just so much bigger.
Yeah. There was a lot of emptying, let me tell you.
The bedroom where Robin's six dogs sleep hadn't been cleared in 5 years.
OK, let's go. Oh,
dear.
Yes.
Oh, lovely. Yes. It's the floor. It's not... got a carpet of clothes. It's wonderful. So much better sleeping in a room like this. looks inviting, looks so crisp and nice.
He's done this for you.
And I appreciate it.
And I hope you do, because he's worked hard for it.
It means a lot to me, what you've done. The house was so bad, I just couldn't stand being in it. I wanted to be with you so much, but I just... The house was such a wedge between us. And I can see you across the room now.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Vinny.
It means a lot. It's a wonderful, wonderful...
thanks, Vinny.
Thank you so much. No,
thanks.
Thank you.
You can enjoy it, Kev. Right.
I do appreciate it.
I really...
All right.
..really appreciate it. Thank you.
I'm just glad I brought these two people together again.
Really?
And I can go away now and think, well, yeah, I did something good. And I'm happy about that. Very.
It's our bedroom now. We'll keep it dog-free. There's no way we're ever going to let this house get so bad again. Ever. No way. I can't go through that again. It looks so nice now. I just want to keep it like this.
I've learned that I'm very proud of my obsession. Even though we've cleaned the house top to bottom, I still couldn't use the toilet. I still couldn't drink out of the tap, because I know I still have those scenarios in my head of all the things that I've uncovered. No way could I do that.
Next time on Obsessive Compulsive Cleaners...
I am stood in poo.
Oscar's the only one that's actually house trained.
The way I live is the correct way to live.
So this is your kitchen.
If you hadn't have got yourself in this mess in the first place, you wouldn't be putting your wife through this.
That was unheard of.
What?
Go home.
I'm here to help you.
If you've been affected by the issues raised in this programme or would like more information, go to channel4.com/support. 8 o'clock tomorrow night, Pear and Stilton Pizza is the hard sell. It's very much all about the fruit in River Cottage to the core. Next tonight, Smuts or Science, either way, it's a reverent drama. Masters of Sex coming up.